Ideal gases don't really exist. But under low pressure and high temperatures, many of the gases that we deal with are close to ideal. And this is really useful for real-world situations, using the gas laws, for example. Very useful. And here's why. For ideal gases, we assume that molecules don't take up any space, even though they do. When we have these low pressures here, though, most of this space is unoccupied, it's empty. So it doesn't matter much that they take up a little bit of space. But if we had more molecules, or we reduced the volume, now it starts to matter, because they're taking up a lot of space in relationship to the entire volume. So under low pressures, where they're spread out more, we have more of an ideal situation. For ideal gases, we're also assuming that they don't really interact with each other. They don't repel or attract. And if we have a large volume here, low pressure, they don't really have a chance to interact. Or if we increase the temperature, they start moving faster, and it's even harder for them to attract or repel each other when they're moving that quickly. So that's the second condition. Since the molecules don't attract or repel, at higher temperatures, we're closer to that ideal. So in short, when we have low pressures or high temperatures, those real gases will be closer to ideal. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.